Today, from Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis, it's Week 18 of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Houston Texans.
First opened back in 2008, there's a look at Lucas Oil Stadium here in downtown Indy. It's all about divisional matchups on this final day of the regular season, and we've got a compelling one in store here, as it'll be the Houston Texans taking on the Indianapolis Colts. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and yes, it's January 7th, but we haven't seen you since New Year's Eve, so we have to say Happy New Year, one and all. And partner, Happy New Year to you. This is it, the conclusion of the 2023 season. Hard to believe, but we got a good one here between division rivals. And you like what the NFL's done here, making Week 18 all division games.
I think it's one of the more inspired moves by the league because they've made these matchups really count. And typically they mean something, not a lot of coasting as people head towards the playoffs. But I do have to ask, January 7th, is it too late to say it? We're kind of right on the borderline, aren't we, about Happy New Year? Because that always seems to be the subject of debate.
So out come the Texans for their opening drive. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
And he's had a great season so far throwing the football. Very likely could go over 4,000 yards with a good performance here. And even in an age of passing first, that is no small accomplishment. Ready, set.
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. They'll take that 14 yards on play number one.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Stroud looking to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Pierce. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Hand off right side to Pierce. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Play three of the drive, not as successful. They go backwards after those two first down gains. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12.
Play action. Stroud now.
Man open. That's complete to Dalton Schultz. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 34-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 34. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Well, this defense for the Colts, they played really well in the win over the Raiders a week ago.
Yeah, they gave up 17 points, but that's what you would consider a goal for each and every defense, because if you give up 17 points a game all year long, you're thinking you're going to be a playoff team because you expect your offense to score more than that. That's what you're looking for. Room to improve, of course, but I'd have to say a very solid performance.
Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. A good pick up there of 20 yards. First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Pierce is into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive in total, 8 plays.
And it was Damian Pierce closing things out with a touchdown run.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away.
McKenzie will not return this, and it'll be brought out to the 25.
So the Colts now coming out for their opening drive.
Leading them out, still one of the most recognizable QBs in the game and one of the most fun QBs in his fifth season, it's Gardner Minshew.
And it felt like it watching the game tape. He got everyone involved last week.
He was a manager.
He really was. That's a great way to put it, because they ran the ball some. They threw it accurately. One touchdown pass, so he didn't, you know, break the bank doing that, but he didn't throw any interceptions. That's the bottom line. That's why a defense loves a quarterback like that. Doesn't put them in bad situations.
They'll run with Taylor to begin the drive.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
And now as we get toward the home stretch here, the regular season, Charles, let's take a look at the list of key inactives for them in this one.
Yeah, and after almost a full season of physical games, you know you're going to have some guys missing during the final weeks of the season. Nature of how we play this sport. Every team, you've got to be prepared to handle them. And the teams that focus on handling it, focus on guys getting ready to play, even if they're not starters, those are the ones that weather the storm.
7 yards on the quick slant and a first down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. Looking to throw it, Minshew. That's complete to his running back, Taylor. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter.
Hey, look at the defense for these Texans.
Right now, they're ranked number 29 in the NFL against the pass, so 4th from the bottom, Charles.
And I think you're going to see some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency.
Now Minshew has it knocked out, fumble.
Offensively lucky there, able to keep the football, but now 4th down, so they'll have to boot it away.
I do think, though, they're going to look at this as a positive. One, they recovered the fumble, so they retained possession. But two, being able to punt it changes field position for them. Imagine if that turnover takes place there. Now your defense has to go onto the field and try and hold. Instead, they get a little breathing room.
Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
Oh, he fakes a spike. And that'll be caught. And they're able to get this one across the 35. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long, had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving core to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Start early.
Yeah, we saw that from up here, CD. A tug on the face mask and the flag comes out.
And we saw that last week they had some defensive miscues like that. And they told us that they had worked hard on it in practice and thought they had it all cleaned up. But obviously the message hasn't really sunk in.
He's going to air it out deep for Woods. Touchdown, Texans! Robert Woods, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Texans have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Well, partner, I mean, if anybody was still questioning whether or not he had an NFL-caliber arm, I think you can toss that right out the window. That was a heck of a throw right there.
I would agree totally. Question it no more. This rookie, big-time throw right there. Great poise, stepped up, trusted he could lay it in there perfectly, and he knew that his guy was going to make the catch on the other end. Nice collaboration.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. McKenzie will not return this, and it'll be brought out to the 25. Second drive coming up here for the Indianapolis Colts. And the stakes in this game certainly high as we get toward the end of the regular season. For now, they are holding a wild card spot, but there are no shortage of other teams in the NFC looking to take that spot from them.
Starting with the guys on the other side of the field because they're on the outside looking in, and no one likes to be in that position. You want to be in the room, not looking inside to see everyone else having fun.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. They go to the ground again with Taylor. A nice little juke. And some space here. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 41. Minshew sets to throw. Over the middle, hauled in by Pierce. And he's taken down inside the 30. 14 yards that time for number 14.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
And these two hooked up on a nice game to play before, and I always admire play callers that see a play that works and go right back to it, so they went right back to him. The reward, they're set up with first and goal.
Taylor gonna be hit and met at the line of scrimmage. They get him down at the 3. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Jonathan Taylor, a touchdown machine. He's going to get plenty of looks down here near the goal line. So if I'm on defense, I might start getting prepared to see his number called a couple more times.
Here's Taylor again. And he takes it in for a Colts score. Jonathan Taylor with his 9th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Colts have cut it back within a score. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that'll make our score 14-7. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Desmond King to return it from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Getting set to go again here, Robert Woods marches back onto the field. And the previous drive put him up over 1,000 yards for the season. So now it's what you like to refer to, my friend, as gravy time, right?
It is. I mean, he's done it, right? He's accomplished the goal. So the good players, they relax a little. They bask in it. They think this is okay. We've done what we set out to do. The great players decide to push that number as high as they possibly can. I don't expect him to have any let up in his game the rest of the way.
Great thing if you're on the opposite side. He's such a weapon. He just opens things up for the other guys around him.
Yeah, if you're the opposite receiver, you should expect a few passes to come your way too, because I've got to kick coverage in his direction.
Pierce will try to pick it up. And he's going to be a yard short. Needed 4, but got 3. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard. Evades the tackler, and now some space. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. Oh, on the defensive side, that is so deflating.
Not only is it deflating, they've got to look in each other's eyes on that side of the ball and take each other's measure. You've got them backed up, perfect situation, and what they said to you on the other side is, we don't...
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. Give him 32 on the play. Now a timeout called for by the offense as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Pierce takes it straight ahead, and he'll get this down only to the 18. Tackle that time by Ronnie Harrison.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense, holding them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the first on third. Stroud sets up the play action. Throw left side complete. That's Schultz. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run here with Pierce. And he'll take this one in for a Texans touchdown. Damian Pierce with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Texans will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. So the rushing touchdowns continue to stack up, CD. That now 15 for him on the year.
And give him a ton of credit for staying healthy, being a smart runner, and it's showing just how important he's been to his team. He's got to be their MVP at this point in the season, and those votes may even turn into league MVP votes when it's all said and done.
So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
The Colts about to go on offense one final time in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A little over 20 seconds remaining in the half as they'll line up here first and 10. Out of the gun is Minshew. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
These two teams, they met up earlier in the year back in week 2. And it was the visiting Colts who won that first matchup. So they'll look for the season sweep here back home in Indy.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Minshew, 1st and 10. This will be taken in by Michael Pittman. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
And going right back to Pittman.
So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much.
Only 30 minutes left in the regular season, and everybody's excited for the playoffs, so we're just going to forget the halftime show and get back to the football. The Colts getting the football first, and they trail here as we are back underway in quarter number three. McKenzie will not return this, and it'll be brought out to the 25. Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. And right out of the gate, they face what you'd think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. On the counter, it's Taylor. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 65 yards rushing for him so far in this one as he nears 1,400 for the year.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Minshew. He'll get this one to Pittman. There he goes, left side. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big play that time on the catch and run. And it'll move the chains.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory, right at the 40. Up the middle, here's Taylor. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Throwing on second down now, Minshew. Over the middle, that's caught by Taylor. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. So they will tread backward on the holding penalty.
And I know that they're going to get coached up and they'll get yelled at a little bit, but let's face it, it is hard not to do at the speed and pace that they play.
Running straight ahead, Taylor. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Now Minshew. He's got the tight end, Mo Alie-Cox. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it makes it 3rd down and 2 yards to go. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. They'll try to throw for it with Minshew. He's got his target. That's complete. And the Colts are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 2.
And this is an offense in need of getting a few good things to happen. Here's one right here. They've had their share of struggles in key moments, but that's a nice throw and nice work after the throw. And they're set up now.
And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Jonathan Taylor. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Colts are back within a score. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. King going to look to bring it out. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here's the Texans offense now, readying for their first possession of the second half. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here. You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on first down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up second and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry, and they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. And they'll go right back to Pierce. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 35, here's second down and 8. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
72 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 43. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Stroud now on second down. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of 34.
Already over 1,000 yards receiving this season. That catch is just going to add to his total. Certainly not resting on his laurels. He's trying to continue to gain as many yards as possible and continue this big season.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. Running it out of the gun with Pierce. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
You know, when this offense gets down here near the end zone, they're going to turn to their bell cow, and this guy's been a touchdown machine all year. Excellent job stopping him there on first down.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Singletary. Touchdown, Houston.
And that right there is a definition of a statement drive. You're in the fourth quarter, trying to get to the finish line, and here they were able to hold the ball for a long time and move it down the field. And how about them finishing it off with the touchdown run? Winning football 101, check that box.
Fairbairn now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it was finished off by a Devin Singletary touchdown run. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. McKenzie will not return this, and it'll be brought out to the 25.
And the Colts getting ready to go. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defensive guy.
What's going on the defensive side?
That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
Call that a very strong gain of 24.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Throwing on first down is Minshew. Out of his hands quickly to Pittman. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march.
But correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. It's a pickup of 12. Second play in a row with a 12-yard gain. Now Minshew on first and 10. Left side, he finds Pierce. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Now a second and 6. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
They'll set up the screen to Taylor.
And give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
They'll come up now, 3rd and 3.
Again, Minshew looking to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his 2nd incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Now Minshew has it knocked out, fumble, and the Texans scoop it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, I don't want to violate any of our broadcasting rules by declaring a game over before it's over. But that one, that puts them in real jeopardy there.
Absolutely. It was a two-possession game. It is a two-possession game at this stage in the 4th. They needed points out of that drive.
And obviously now, no chance at all to get those points that they so desperately needed.
86 yards rushing for him here as he starts to draw closer to a 1,000-yard campaign.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Here's Pierce on the counter.
Now the Colts going to burn the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Second and 5. Another carry for Pierce. And the Texans are going to have a first down, and that is a big one, as they should be able to run it out from here. Pierce now up the middle.
Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
So they come up on 2nd down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
And they'll run with Pierce.
And yeah, maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line.
A big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
To Inigo Stroud, and that is going to be all she wrote.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one.
Well, CD, for the losing side, they had opportunities in this one, but big plays just didn't go their way, especially late, and they have to suffer the L here.
It certainly felt like that takeaway, once it happened, it knocked the wind out of their sails, and they just couldn't get their equilibrium back.
So for the Texans,
they get that important 10th win to finish the regular season at 10-7.
And that is maybe not exactly what they were hoping for, but a better than average season nonetheless. Meanwhile, for the Colts,
it's a tough loss to take as they'll finish things off at 9-8.
But they